Genie Mini 2 is the next generation of our original Genie Mini. On the Genie Mini 2 itself, there is a 1/4-inch thread on the top and a 3/8-inch thread on the bottom. Also included in the base is a 1/4-inch thread adapter. You can take this adapter out depending on if you want to attach it to a tripod head or tripod legs. In the box, you will find a USB-C charging cable. Use this with a USB wall adapter or plug it into any USB port to charge. Also included is a USB-C to USB-A cable. This is useful for some of our more advanced features, including camera control and automatic exposure ramping. One end goes into the Genie Mini 2, and you should connect the other end to the USB cable that comes with your camera. This is only possible with some camera models, and these features will be released in the future. Please check the website for up-to-date feature release information. On the right, there is a 2.5mm plug used to connect to your link cable for triggering the shutter of your camera, a USB-C port for charging or connecting the camera for camera control, and a power button. Press the on button once to turn on Bluetooth. A flashing light means Bluetooth is ready, and you can connect using the app. To turn off, hold for about 1 to 2 seconds until you see the lights flash, and then let go. You can download the Syrp Genie 2 app from the App Store on Android or iPhone. Turn the device on and tap the connect icon in the top right. The Genie Mini 2 will appear. Just tap the circle to connect. If the firmware is out of date, you'll be prompted to update the firmware. Tap update. Once updated, you can rename your device by tapping the pencil icon. Otherwise, hit back. Tap settings to change the default settings of the app. Shutter signal should be left to default. However, some cameras require a longer shutter signal in order to trigger, so you can change this here if you need to. You can switch the measurement units between imperial or metric, depending on your preference. Default frame rate should match with the frame rate you will typically use in editing. If you're not sure, select 30fps for the US, and for everywhere else, set it to 25fps. About displays which firmware and app version you currently have on the device. Tap Create Content to begin setting up a movement. Here you can select from either an advanced keyframing option or a quick setup option. In this tutorial, we will explore time-lapse and video through quick setup modes. For advanced keyframing setup and other tutorials, check out our YouTube channel. Let's tap time-lapse. Here you can select from a number of different presets where the movement and timing parameters are predefined. To customize your own settings, tap New Setup. To start setting up your time-lapse, first set your start point by dragging the on-screen joystick to where you want to begin your movement. As you drag, the Genie Mini will move with it. Set how many degrees you wish to pan, then drag the camera icon to the endpoint. Here, you can move the endpoint while the camera icon is locked to the end and frame up where you want to finish your movement. Once you're done, tap Return Home. With the movement set, now adjust your time-lapse settings. Starting with record time, let's say we want to run this recording for 1 hour. Then adjust your interval. That's how often you want to take a photo. If you have fast-moving objects in your scene, such as people, then we recommend a lower interval, say 3 seconds. If you have slower-moving objects, then choose a longer interval, like 5 or 10 seconds. The playtime shows you how long your final time-lapse will be once you compile it later. If you prefer, you can adjust the playtime and the interval will update automatically. Lastly, you can also set your ease in, ease out. This gives you a smoother, fluid motion at each end of your move. So if I change it to 3 seconds, it means the first and last 3 seconds of my time-lapse will slowly ramp in and out. Now that all your parameters are set, you can also preview your move. Tapping Preview will show you the exact speed of your movement when you compile the time-lapse later. If you're happy, hit record to run your time-lapse. If you want more control or something doesn't look quite right, you can jump into the advanced settings. To start with, tap the 3 dots to open them up. Here, you can change the frame rate of your recording. It's important to match this frame rate to your editing timeline or other footage that you'll be using. The movement type for time-lapse is usually set to Move, Shoot, Move, meaning that the Genie Mini 2 will move and come to a complete stop before firing the shutter. Changing it to continuous means that the Genie Mini will continuously move without stopping to fire the shutter, just like video mode. This is useful for cameras that cannot be triggered by the Genie Mini 2, such as GoPros or smartphones. Move Shoot Delay refers to the wait time between the movement and when the camera is fired. You shouldn't need to change this, but you can increase it if you have an unstable or shaky setup. Lastly, you can save your setup as a preset so you can quickly access it later. For video, tap the icon and switch to video mode. The setup dial is exactly the same, however this time you'll want to set how long you want to record for, which decides how fast or slow your movement will be. You can also change your record type to bounce. This way it will bounce back and forward running the same movement. Ease in and out and settings are the same as in time-lapse mode. In video mode, using the link cable to start your camera won't work, so just tap Rec on your camera, then Rec on the app to run a movement. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the Syrp channel for more tips, tutorials, and filmmaking guides.